Hi everyone and welcome to my channel for a new interview with a very fascinating guest, Ricardo Moniz. Ricardo, thank you again for accepting my invitation. How are you doing?
Yeah, tired. Three trainings a day, so always tired.
Oh wow.
Always.
But that's the price to get to be fit like you.
Yeah, still I'm almost 60. You want to be every day a better footballer. That's something in me that drives me, you know. Every day you want to be better. And to be honest, how more you train when you get older, how better you become. It's very, very remarkable. And that's interesting because you have more influence on the players, especially this generation, you know. And we must in fact be player trainer coach. That's something what I'm obsessed in, player trainer coach.
Yeah, exactly. Ricardo, you've been football trainer coach, as you said, for many renowned clubs throughout your career, sometimes in youth development, sometimes with the first teams, and sometimes both at the same time. I mean, the list is very long. Feyenoord, PSV, Grasshoppers, Tottenham, Hamburg, the Red Bull clubs, Ferencváros, and now you're head of player development at FC Zurich's academy. We will talk about your role at your new club later in the emission, but I'd like to come back to the roots, since as a young coach, you had the chance to directly learn deeply from Cruyff and from Will Kerber. Could you please explain to us how did you manage to get in touch with them at that time? And above all, how did they shape you as a coach?
Now, first of all, I'm lucky. When I was 6 years old, I'm raised in the time of Cruyff and 60s, when Ajax and Feyenoord and the Dutch national football became world famous. So Cruyff's debut goes parallel on my, yeah, when I was 3, 4 years, when we had the television in the time, black white. Yeah, and there's one man accelerating over the pitch, changed the football like no one before, because we were very static in Holland. I always want to be number one, be the favorite. And yeah, that inspired me how football had to be played. Later, you became in 74 obsessed how football was in total football terms almost perfect, because we lost the final against Germany. But that whole generation from Cruyff inspired me how I later became coach, but also how I want to be as player. So I trained more than my friends to be more explosive, to have better left and right foot. So the function of a footballer like Cruyff, he was an example to inspire whole generations. And the generation today is more boring, more selfish, less sharing to inspire. And it worries me for the future when not new Johan Cruyff will come, then the football will die. Will Kerver is another story. Will Kerver was my teacher. I met him in 1981 when I was professional. I was very young professional in Eindhoven. And yeah, he started his method, you know, in 1981. And one training, yeah, he already convinced me that every player, no matter how old he is, can be a better footballer. Now, later I followed him, and in the latest phase, he became my partner to share a lot of experiences. And unfortunately, he died in 2011. I mean, yeah, 2011.
Yeah. And I found a compilation of quotes from you on an online article by Gary Hoyland, someone who seems to also have learned directly from Will Kerber. So correct me if it's wrong, but you once said that Kerber's name was used commercially, but one will only find 5% of his real method and philosophies in exchange of a lot of money. Because nowadays, if you say Kerber, one will think of ball mastery and 1v1. But even if we only focus on those two things, it's the exercises Will Kerber chose and the way he coached them that made him special, right?
Yeah, look, he told me the story. He sold his rights in that time. And in that time, the method was not so complete like later. The people did a good job, but only used the beginning of his method. I think every coach must be own-headed to develop the method further in his personality. So he gave us an unbelievable basic. And I know a lot of trainers from Curve who developed in the own, who nobody knows, who are not connected with Curve coaching. So it's not about Curve. He only said we train the qualities for the top players, and especially the 95% not naturally gifted talents. Only 5% is Cruyff, Eusebio, Di Stefano, Maradona. The other 95% have to work to become, have that qualities. And that's why he made that method.
Yeah, and now if we talk about your work, you've coached many top players, but who would you say is the one who most benefited or improved under you? Because the one who naturally came to my mind is Robin van Persie. Of course, a very intelligent player, technically very on point, but he also seemed to have more than anyone else this desire, this anger you represent as a coach, or is it Harry Kane, maybe?
Yeah, look, when you talk about Harry Kane, Robin van Persie, it's like with us. They always say, oh, it's not good enough. It's the story of everybody. Everybody is underestimated. Robin, they want to send away in Feyenoord in 1997. Harry Kane, they want to send away at Tottenham. That's always the success story, that people start to fight when they're underestimated. I think Messi was very small. Johan Cruyff was too thin. Frank Lampard is sent away by West Ham United. Ed Cadavis was not good enough. You know, it's always the story of the underdog. And then you start as coach to fight hand in hand with them, with the method of Mr. Curver, with 400 repetitions a day, to develop their strength. The only thing what made Robin so big, he wanted to be number one. He don't stand behind the tree. And he wanted to invest. So every free day, also when I left Feyenoord and I was trainer for PSV, he came on his free day to practice with me 3-4 hours. Now, and that's talent. It's working talent. But you look, when you ask me that question, everybody wants to have a name, but I also have trained people who nobody knows who are interesting. And I always want to be on the side of people who are underestimated. So also there you make a lot of improvement. Also people in the grassroots. I developed coaches in the grassroots. I've trained with the poor neighborhoods in Tottenham. You know, you have 12 academies from poor neighborhood. Tottenham, Brixton, where a lot of violence. And through the ball, we can reach the heart of the kids. You can develop the character structure. So hand in hand with the technical improvement, you develop the character development as positive leader, take initiative, have social interaction. The strongest help the weakest. And the society changed. I saw that happening in London, where parents came to me, hey, my kid is changing. He's different, more open. Train 1 hour with the ball, not with the iPhone, not with the joystick, with the ball. So all the people who listen now to this podcast, they make the difference. When they stand open to be a father figure, hand in hand with us trainer coach, they can change the world. You can change only through the ball, the heart of the kids. Even when you go to school to learn for, with all the respect, physiotherapist, but that teacher don't comes in the heart of the kids. The trainer coach who let them make 200 actions a day, inspires them. They change the character from every kid. And that's what you started my world trip. Thanks God I could, thanks to the ball, I meet you. Thanks to the ball, I could see the whole world. And the ball have a massive influence in all problems. If it's racism, if it's arrogance of people, because football is honest. When you as creative midfielder scores 20 goals, it's honest or not. Now, that's the Curver method, not only the skill. Now, it's the production to score goals. The creativity is only measured in the final third and your own final third, because the one against one is not explained only offensive. Now, you also create exceptions defensively. The Maldinis, the Davids, the Roy Keens, the killers in behind, and the players up front we have to produce, you know? And then I'm convinced when you start at 6 years with that method, you don't have to buy. You can produce 50% from the own homegrown, you know, situation. And that's also important that you create a value from your own, how you say, Switzerland, Austria. But yeah, also here in Switzerland, we have problems. There's not one new Messi. or new Ronaldo, you know, up front. It's all okay, but it's not exception. So maybe people are satisfied, or they say it's impossible, but nothing is impossible.
Yeah, that's not how football can not only be inspiration but also education, as you said. And you also said that you had impact on football coaches, and one of them is Pep Einleinders, Jurgen Klopp's famous assistant coach at Liverpool. And he said that you shaped him as a coach when he assisted you at PSV, but I still would like to know if he brought the same methodology to Porto a few years later, because I've seen videos from his work there where it was about different development stages. Can you tell us more about it?
Pijn is extreme. Eh? He's fantastic, also communicator. He wants to make every player better. He's interested every day. He studied. He invested 24 hours in his life work, because unfortunately, well, he was a good player. Sometimes there are coaches who didn't make the professional career, and a lot of that coaches are extra focused to be a top trainer. Now he became that. In Porto, he made the flat goals videos. I saw that, the curve goals. Fantastic. How he works in Liverpool, I think different. I think in Liverpool, there's more focus on intensity. But I don't have enough contact with him to know how he works at the moment. But that he was a big, big talent in that time of PSV Eindhoven, yeah, that was clear in 1 week. The way how he approached and recognized the work was unbelievable. And he can be very proud on himself that he's so long time on the top.
Yeah, and talking about this, the video I've seen were notably about practicing skills unopposed and then with a passive defender, which I find very interesting. And like many coaches who are very pessimistic when it comes to developing creativity, because for them, dribblers are a gift from God, either you're born like this or not. And although some morphologies must help, I'm sure we could at least develop more players who can comfortably get out of pressure, because I've had players quite clean technically, for example, but when they had to receive with an opponent in their back, they just lacked ideas, you know?
Yeah, look, you can't change that kind of coaches. They have all the right to be who they are. That's also the interesting thing in life. Nobody is the same, and everybody must stay himself. But yeah, you and I, we believe that you can learn things. The method of Curver, the how you say it, if you beat 400 times a day your opponent, you get better in that. When I cross 400 times with my left foot, I get better in that. Johan Cruyff, when you see his last year in Feyenoord in 1994, he developed not only his right outside foot in the space, 40-meter pass, also left. And that he developed in his last year. So it doesn't matter how old you are, you can still develop your technical ability, left and right. Because when I ask now a kid who have two outside foots, nobody. Mention one player now this year who have two outside foots. Modric have right, eh? But not left.
Well, I can't and
one. Yeah. Now, that's something what is an interesting detail. Because football is only about creating scoring chances. And yeah. But people have to be interested. You can't convince people who are pessimistic. Let them stay pessimistic and go another way. You know, don't disturb us. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But don't
yeah.
get irritated. That's important.
Yeah. We need to focus on our
yeah.
work, on ourselves.
Yeah.
Now talking about this lack of creativity, we might see, is it something you find is more present in Switzerland than in other countries you've been
yeah.
to? Because
yesterday I saw then our team against Basel. It's 0-0. That means there is no creativity. Yeah, you understand?
Yeah. Yeah, because when my impression when I see under 13 or 14 international tournaments is most of our kids here in Switzerland are actually quite shy compared to kids from other countries, surely out of respect. And so maybe we should try to encourage them to express themselves more, since kids barely play in the streets here, and that's what the streets allows, you know?
Yeah, you can only do in your spontaneous character to take risks. That's how I am as a person. I want to contribute on the Swiss football. I did that 24 years ago with Piet Hamberg and Grasshoppers, and there it worked. We trained 7 o'clock in the morning, the coaches. 8 o'clock, the group of Stefan Liechtensteiner came, and Stefan Liechtensteiner was a very average, normal player with an unbelievable hunger. And later he became player of Juventus. So nothing is impossible. Reto Ziegler was there, Milos Milenovic, Vero Zalatic. So, and there I learned Switzerland. No, it's very open for creativity and flair. That was the old times, eh? That was in 2000. So Switzerland was very open for flair. In fact, the city Zurich also is like Amsterdam. But there's one difference. In Amsterdam, they produced millions, you know, with flair players like Frenkie de Jong, Matthijs de Ligt. So I think a city like Zurich, the fans of Zurich, is very open for that, to create their own homegrown stars with flair, with example function, you know, as good person, but also with a lot of balls to be number one. Because Frenkie de Jong, 80 million, Ajax earns by the transfer from Barcelona. So you also have to create value. Ajax lost that identity a little bit the last years because they don't accept Cruyff really from the heart. They do if, you know, but Johan made there the revolution. He died for it, eh? And then he's dead, and they do what they want. That's now the arrogance of Ajax. You must always be loyal to the people who shaped us, who created the top qualities, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And the new generation computer coaches and, you know, for the laptop coaches have to conform themselves on the romantic and the idealism of football. When they mix and we work together, we can make steps, but not when they dominate. When the computer coaches and the very distant people, you know, are negative, overrules now the football, we have to fight. The football is changed because of them. That's why you create robots. But when they work together with type like us, then we improve. Because, of course, you need more science in some situations, sprint capacity. But people must start to work together. Be
yeah.
open. And a lot of people do if, but are not real.
Yeah, arrogance won't
you
bring
understand?
You won't really won't
yeah,
bring
and that,
you
and
far.
That happens now in Ajax. And who's the victim? That are the fans of Ajax, the tradition. And I can be very upset about that other subject.
Yeah, yeah,
other
yeah.
Subject.
Yeah, and now talking about, actually, we need as coaches to transmit confidence, notably on the ball. And I heard you used to give the kids homework by asking them to train certain moves and show them the next week. Is it something you're going to implement in Zurich? Because training when no one is watching surely
you
can
can only
help.
work. I'm not important. You only offer if you want to be a top footballer, you can make it. Especially in the modern football, where also runners and dynamic qualities are more appreciated than in our time. In the past, you must be good on the ball. Otherwise, you know, in the past was more technical intelligence. You had almost in every team, also in the youth types, you had killers in the back, you had wingers with speed, you had typical strikers in the box, and you had creativity on the midfield. That was a natural process in every youth team you came. Now you hardly can find. Everybody is the same. But now, if you offer the homework, it's not only the technique what I give them. The wall, you know, I have the film wall training that I train still half an hour a day with the wall. Opponent frontal, opponent in the back, opponent on the side. Kicking with 2 foot every time you accelerate. You know?
That's
but who, who makes that?
self-discipline.
But who makes that half an hour a day? The wall. Who makes that? Who makes half an hour a day sprint training? Who makes half an hour a day endurance training? So you need to be complete. You must master every system. You can't only train the sprint capacity. You must also train the endurance in the forest. If all the systems are top, your food, your lifestyle, your own opinion, not your agent decides, you decide. He's for the paperwork. and for, you know, be a kind of father figure. They must trust their intuition. You know, you know, for example, you go to a club, your agent say, yeah, you have to sign here, but you have a cold feeling. You don't feel happy. Don't do it. Make your own decisions outside of the pitch, in the pitch. Because at the moment they come here at the first team in Zurich, they must have an own opinion. Otherwise, the dressing room will not accept you. So the youth development have to be a complete father figure role to protect them for what is coming. You know, that's a very hard world. We both love the ball, but the world around it is very, very tough. And we must protect. So to train only on the ball is not enough. You must also be in the gym. You must also be in the forest. But on the end, of course, the football behavior in the pitch decides. You must have a weapon.
Yeah, you know, it's a whole package.
Yeah, or you are exception in Puyol, or you're exception in Xavi, or you're exception in Messi. In some things, you must have a weapon. And that worries me at the moment. In Zurich, I want to see what's your weapon.
Yeah.
And that's now the positive provocation with the kids. But they're very top here. The whole club is top. So I have a good impression of Switzerland. Yeah, of Zurich. I have a good impression of Zurich. They really want to be number one. But now, yeah, it's only one number one. Eh?
Yeah.
Now the truth comes out.
That's why we need a process for them to develop. And here in Switzerland, the first official elite age group is under 12. Some will maybe find it late, but I still think it's a delicate state for many kids because they used to be the best of their village club in under 11. And suddenly, all these kids that used to be significantly better than the others play against kids of the same level or better. So do you think that more than any other category, it's important to have this special attention to being comfortable on the ball at that age here? Because if you don't take risks in under 12, it will be more difficult to take some in older categories where you have less time to do it.
But what do you mean about good on the ball? It never ends, huh? Good on the ball. What do you mean?
That there's a step in the level that is quite big between under 11 and under 12, where all the best kids join the academies and play to against each other. So I can see some of them, like they feel they don't take risks because it's another game. I need to play, like I don't have to make mistakes, so I will play easy.
Yeah, but I think first of all I feel a little bit that you're a kind of stress or fear that must go out of the football. Football is pleasure, innocence, be who you are. So that's one that's important for coaches. So the fear doesn't exist normally, so it should be. And from there, when you come to better players with maybe bigger physique and you are a good dribbler in your own neighborhood, you play on your intelligence. You play as a playmaker who feeds the team. I had the same experience. I was 2 years younger when I was going to Eindhoven. And I less played on my dribbling skills. I played in the middle. I played on serving the team. Play gap passes. So you get more tactically shaped. Later, after 15 years, you get a little bit more, testosterone. Then you can train more your explosivity, your distance shot. And because I've trained more than my friends who were better, I was 70 years when I played in the first team. So the key is when you do more than your concurrents who are maybe more naturally gifted, you will make it 100%. And that key the coaches must give, not to be busy with themselves, with their own tactical shape or with their own match plan, you know, the ball orientated pressing, the man marking. It's a natural process. Every coach knows it now. But to create a higher percentage homegrown production, you know, like in the past La Masia, the time for Messi, Xavi, Valdes, Piquet, Iniesta. So it should be. Now, when even Ajax have lost that identity, that's a big sign for the world. So it's very important now to restore the tradition of football, get the types back, get the freedom back of expression, and every country must produce their own people from their own country. You know what I mean? And that's now very interesting. And also we in Grasshoppers in that time, we didn't manage it. Only Liechtensteiner made it. The rest didn't make it. So also Grasshoppers was a very bad example for giving the youth the chance. Although I appreciate and thankful for the time, but they had no balls to put enough players in the first team. It only has to do with balls, what Cruyff did with Bergkamp, Aaron Winter, Brian Roy, Marco van Basten. You know what I mean? And
yeah,
and so
door,
it should. Sorry?
The door needs to be open if you want.
Yeah,
to.
Of course, and give them trust and develop them. But they must train 2-3 times a day. Eh? A lot of professional now. They train one time a day. That's no top sport. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I see that. And
everybody wants to be Ronaldo, Modric, but they are 24 hours focused then. So we also must learn them that. So and give them the warmth, the innocence, who are you? But you have to kill them when they're lazy.
That's how it works. That's nature, actually. And talking about implementing things from your methodology at FC Zurich, how does your day-to-day life beside your freshly added under 21 coaching role look like? Because it was announced that you would have this coach of the coaches role, but I assume you also give training sessions in other age groups to inspire.
Look, now it changed. Now I have I'm trainer coach again from under 21.
Yeah.
I still have that coach the coaches a little bit on the side because I did that three months. Now I was clear enough to them and I trust them. They can do it because they must be independent. On the side, tomorrow morning, I have 50 players, but the coaches in Syria are very intelligent. So what you show them, they can do themselves. What you show a player, you must do tomorrow. So independent everybody must be. You must not spoil people. And now is the truth also for me, with all my experience, yeah, this is your life work. Now you must show something will have to change. You understand? And something have to change because the system is not right. We buy, we buy, we buy. But we must create and buy the exception to get one level higher. You know, in Europe, for example. Now then everybody must be critical to themselves. Was I good enough? That's life. Every day it's your last. Every day you must train if you're last, 120%. Now, and that's now a challenge for me. What can I make? And you never know the truth. You try to, I say, to give all the methodologies to the players. But what comes out, we can say in May, end of the season. If it is changed, if we have more exceptions, if we have the sprint capacity from Leipzig, from Salzburg, who as underdog club attacked the top, you know?
Yeah.
And that's very interesting. And a lot of top clubs now with the big names, they fall away from the top, you know? They're all fallen top clubs. You know them also.
Yeah, and that's interesting. I really like the fact that you mentioned that you need to give liberty. You can give keys, ideas to coaches, but in the end, you have to let them with their liberty because it's otherwise they won't be happy as well.
Yeah, it's up to them, but they make the difference. My youth coach, when you have a youth coach who have confidence in you, your career goes like that. So they must be a game changer in the lives of kids. Also after us, that Zurich built their own DNA, that you have here the best methods. It's not about a name of Curve or Ricardo or Cruyff. It's the qualities from the top players.
Yeah.
Yeah. You train the qualities of the top players. Simple or not simple? That's simple. Football is simple. But people must want it. And sometimes I feel on people, they prefer to stand behind the tree. Don't be want to be favorite. You know what I mean? Don't want to invest like Ronaldo, like Davids, like Van Nistelrooy, like Lampard, like Steven Gerrard. They were working talents. And in every profession, they make the top.
Yeah, comfort is the
Stay
enemy.
For Liechtensteiner, eh? Sorry?
Comfort is the enemy.
Yeah, comfort. Never in the comfort. I traveled to 15 countries. You must never be in comfort zone. Every day you must train that what you can't. Not what you can. What you can, you don't have to train. You must train what you can't.
Yeah, you learn in difficulty. And Ricardo, already the last question. Your team is the last step before the one of Bo Henriksen. And some of your players like Kalix Klig, Labinot Bayrami, the Reichmuth brothers, new recruit Joseph Sabobanda, and maybe Levio Di Giusto as well, might soon be ready to make it to the first team. So how is the relationship with Bo Henriksen, or is it new academy director Sasha Milicevic who knocks on his door to tell him, I think this guy is ready or should train with you?
3 months is too short to get top relationships that develops over a longer term. You mentioned a few young players, fantastic top players, eh? But don't forget the other 100. We also have the Albie Hall, you know, the old legend. I call him George Best, Albie Hall. There it starts. He's a very underestimated man. And a lot of coaches you don't mention now, they are very important. They are the fundament of the club. We have here a lot of people, the cleaning ladies, the people. We are one club. They are the basic of the pyramid. And I think they're on the good way. We are now in the phase of getting each other know that players are all top talents. The question is how dominant they can profile themselves that the first team coach and the cabin will accept them. That's a matter of how dominant are you and how confident are you in your strength. That's what I tell you. That's in May. We have a clearer picture about that. But everybody, everything is here in a city like Zurich to reach the same what we did in Salzburg or in Leipzig.
That's good. Interesting. That's good news for Swiss football. Ricardo, thank you for your time. It's been a pleasure to have you on the channel, and all the best for you in Switzerland.
Thank you, Maxime. All the best. Bye.